So in closing, I've been up so long. It is now almost 1:30 in the A to the M's, but I was having some free thought and I was just like, you know what? No, this is a good opportunity to get this out. This is important. On 7/7, I was just talking about how, like, I realized that for 11 years, I failed my daughter. And I can admit that. For 11 years. But it wasn't, even though with how I'm saying I failed her, I know that I really didn't fail her. Because somewhere within her little body, there's trust for me. And enough trust to tell me things. And I'm so thankful that I have instilled something in her. Ooh, I'm so cold. To have her to the point where she can just tell me what's going on. You know, of course, as a parent, when you hear shit and it's late, of course, you know, you're like, why you didn't tell me when it happened? Yes, of course, yes. But still, they told you. And whenever they feel comfortable to tell you, that is when you should handle it. Because that is when you know. And what should piss you off even more is if they tell you some shit, and it's some shit that you know the other person know that they did, and it was a while ago, and this motherfucker is just parading around you like shit is sweet. I said, I'm gonna let it go. This is about my baby. The OG baby girl. You know, like I said, I'm thankful that she came to me and trust me enough to talk to me. And I owe her so much. Like, I owe her so much. Like, I only got 7 years left. 7 years to instill whatever else I can instill in her to make sure that she is the best human being she can possibly be out here in these streets, because shit is gonna get real. It's already real, but it's really gonna get real by the time she, and then by the time my little ones, we are talking some real shit. And I'm just trying to create human beings who at least know at the foundation, at the core of how to be great human beings. I'm going to have to probably apologize to my daughter as she gets older, or once she gets older, and she starts really realizing some shit after she's had more experiences. The same way. The same way this shit came to me when I needed to do it to my own mom. I'm going to have that shit. I'm going to have that same shit. But I know how to handle it. I know it's coming. And I'm going to take accountability and be like, yes, baby, I fucked up. If I fucked up, I fucked up. But all I can say to that is, and I'm shaking because, you know, niggas got a little iron shit. A little iron gang stand up, just real slow. All I can say to that is just humans are going to be humans. We don't, for the most part, we don't intentionally mean to hurt another human or to fuck up another person's vibe. It's just computer light. It's just shit happens. Shit happens, but you learn as you go. And when you learn and you know better, you do better. And I hope it shows that every time something was brought to me, anytime something was brought to me, I handled it right then and there. Even if I needed like a day or two just to process, it didn't take much longer than that. It didn't get to the point where shit could happen again. Not one time. And it won't ever. Because, ooh, I'm shaking like a stripper. Because I love you. And I'm supposed to protect you. That is my duty. That is my job. No matter how much you beat me up as you get older because of some shit that I might have did that you didn't understand at the time. Now you have understanding. Now let me help you understand what was going on. So, yeah, man, don't. My thing is just don't be afraid to apologize to your kids. Like, I know in my generation, we come from that time of like, you know, you stay in a child's place and all of this shit. Like, we know them sayings, trust me. We know them shits backwards and forwards. And we didn't play with that shit. Like, we was not playing with our grandmas. Like, we wasn't playing with our momos. We was not playing. We weren't playing with Popo either. Mm-mm. But at the same time, they had their demons. And they were fighting their shit. But they were projecting a lot of their shit. And they didn't take accountability. And we didn't learn to take accountability. And now we're at a place where motherfuckers want to talk about accountability. But ain't nobody ever learned how to take fucking accountability. It's an acquired skill. You have to want to do that shit. You have to really want to work to take accountability. Because that shit is not easy to just be like, you know what? When I said that shit that one time, I was kind of tripping, right? No, for real though, I really was tripping. Like, it's not that difficult to say. People just, I don't know what this fixation with wanting to be right. I just don't know. And that's so crazy because that is something that he would say a lot. Like when I would say something to him or whatever, and it would be like the right shit. He'd be like, oh, there she go, always want to be right. But he would really always want to be right. And I'm like, I don't ever want to always be right. Like, I don't aspire to just always be right, nigga. I'm totally fine with somebody coming to me and questioning what the fuck I got going on. Like, okay, I can choose not to answer if I don't fucking feel like it. I can. But I'm not going to run from the debate. I'm either going to debate, or not debate, but just converse, which one of them is not the word. You know what the fuck I mean. We gonna do that shit. And we gonna be good. Do you feel me? But we gonna do that. And that's it. Or I'm just not gonna wanna do it. But yeah, I don't ever. So coming from who we got our shit from, everybody's talking about breaking generational curses, all of this flim flam shit. But people just not understanding that we don't have the skills to do the shit. We don't have the fucking tools. The toolbox is right there, right? There go the toolbox. We see it. There go the fucking shit from IKEA. I never bought anything from IKEA in my life, but I hear things. I hear great things. But there go the shit that we gotta build. And it ain't even, here go the crazy part. The shit that we gotta build, here go the crazy part. The shit that we gotta build ain't even that fucking difficult to build. What if it's like, what if it's like three fucking pieces? But the fucked up part about it is even though it's three fucking pieces, when we open the goddamn toolbox that's full of tools, it's full of shit. It's full of shit. Tools on tools on tools. Full of shit. When we open the toolbox, searching around for the one fucking tool that we need to fix this goddamn thing with the three pieces, that shit ain't in there. Or, you might find a piece of it in there, but you ain't got the whole fucking thing. So you don't even know how the motherfucker's supposed to look. You got part of it. You got an idea of what the fuck it looks like. But you have no clue. There can be so many fucking ways that this shit can end. So that's how it is. It's not that we don't have tools, because everybody has tools. But it's just that one fucking tool or those few tools that you might need to do the thing, you just don't have. But everybody's demanding the thing from everybody. But everybody's not doing the work. And the work requires, in order for you to get the tool or the tools or the rest of the tool, is you have to look at this fucking object and this thing that you have to build and just realize, like, and then kind of like almost like put the tool together in your mind or get with like minds. Who else got some shit like this? Who else do some shit like this? Is there anybody who's already done this shit? Because you, that's what we like, instruction. Is there instructions? Are there any instructions? Is there any kind of blueprint? Did anybody else already do this shit? Nobody else did this shit? Nobody did this? Okay. Okay. So I will be the first. Or, oh, somebody already did this. Okay, well, if they already did this, then there should be some instructions, right? There should be a manual. Oh, there's so many different manuals. Well, where's the original? Oh, there's so many copies of the original. We don't even know where the original is. So I'm just picking up shit as I go, trying to figure out if this is going to put the tool together to get the shit done. And you can, I mean, either way, you slice the shit. Whatever you got to do, it takes work. All of that shit takes work. And you have to want to do that shit. Like, it's not just no, yeah, I'm going to work on accountability today. The hell? The hell? I mean, yeah. But, okay. Shit. It takes work. And don't be here talking about you ready to do it. And then the next day you like, yeah, accountability. No, not for me. What the hell you mean? What you mean? What you mean it's not for you? You just said, I'm ready to take accountability today. That was yesterday. No. This is every day. This is every day. Until you die. Until this die. Every day. Oh man, I just get through the best way I can. My defense mechanisms pop out all the time. And laughter is definitely one. Joking is definitely one, because it feels so good to laugh when all you've done is cry, when all you think about doing is crying, when you fantasize about crying. It's like, and right before all this fucking crying, I just said, I was like, why does it feel like spirit wants me to cry? But what is there to cry about? What is there to cry for? This is something I literally said right before all this shit popped off. Right before all this shit. I was like, why does it feel like Spirit wants me to cry? What the hell is going on between the sheets up in my home? Ugh. We gonna be all right. Kendrick told me that. We gonna be all right. That's what he said. And I believe him. Because he said it. Shit. All right, man. I'm gonna get out of here. I do eventually have to go to sleep. And I would stay up late as hell. On the day that I gotta get up early anyway, because we got an appointment and shit. But I got a lot of work done, and I'm so fucking proud of myself. I'm so fucking proud of me just continuously keeping on, whatever. You know what I mean. I'm just proud of myself because this is not easy. This is really not easy. Not only to just get the emotions out, but to just see it back. Most of the time, I just go through my shit, and that's it. I just experience it, and I just go through it. But now it's like I get to experience it, and then I have to run it back and see it, and see how it just... Can we just say I'm excited to see where this journey takes us? I am so excited. We are going to become so, so cool. Just off the strength of just vibes. That's it. Not just because we got shit going on in life and we need to talk about it. Like, yeah, cool. We talk about our shit. We get through our shit. We do what we do. But we going to kick it because just vibes, nigga. Just, let's just kick it. Let's just kick it. So thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you for showing up for yourself. I love you. Take care of yourself. Drink your water. Mind your goddamn business. I fucking love you, bro. I'm so tired. I'm about to go in between the sheets.